While everyone and their uncle in the tech space right now is talking about that new Mac Pro from Apple, I just wanted to drop in my two cents on why I went with the iMac Pro instead. What's up guys, I'm Ben from AuthenTech, and here's the short story. Now I've been making YouTube videos for about 5 years now, full time, and then I was making client videos before that. I've always been a Final Cut fan, and thus I'm stuck on the Mac platform. I bought my first iMac way back in 2011. It was that standard 27-inch model, and honestly, it worked well for photo and video editing. I was able to make it last until 2014, and then upgraded to the iMac 5K, purchased for around $3,400. It was a fantastic machine and lasted me for about 5 years. And it was only until recently when it started bogging down when I was editing two or three simultaneous streams of 4K and Final Cut for those side-by-side comparisons. I also had some random power shutdowns and a few other bugs here and there. So just a few months ago, I decided to make the investment and upgrade, and after lots of research in between the latest iMac 5K or the iMac Pro or that Mac Pro that was about to be released at the end of this year, I had purchased a refurbished iMac Pro for about $6,000, which is a lot of money. But the specs are very good. 3 GHz, 10 cores, 64 gigs of memory, and that Pro Vega 64 graphics card with 16 gigs. It has Thunderbolt and USB-C and plenty of USB-A ports, and it has the SD card built in and a 5K res screen. It's amazing for content creation and playback of my 4K video files. Right away, I noticed how fast and snappy the new machine was, and editing in the timeline and scrubbing playback was so much faster and responsive. And honestly, it's a very awesome machine. I'm really thankful for it. Exporting times were flying out of Final Cut and definitely fast enough for my needs. Now, when I compare it to that new Mac Pro, base specs of 3.5 gigahertz, 8 cores, 32 gigs of RAM, you're already at that $6,000 base price, and then it rockets upward fast with upgrades. Now, of course, it's expandable and it's much more easy to upgrade now or in the future, but no 5K monitor is included, and for my needs, the iMac Pro should last me years into the future with fast and efficient video editing workflow, and I'm still editing everything in 4K. And of course, you could make the argument that building a custom PC is going to be better for your price to features ratio, but unfortunately, I tried Adobe Premiere and found it still not as fast or efficient as Final Cut. Even rendering and export times on Final Cut seem to beat out Premiere, so I'm still stuck on the Mac. And don't forget those Pro Display XDRs for another $6,000 each. You'll probably want two of those at least for your editing needs, and those $1,000 stands. Honestly, it's pretty smart of Apple because they know plenty of people will just add it to cart, no problem. $400 for some wheels, and that's just a sneeze. There's the law of diminishing returns, and the iMac Pro will do more than enough for my needs. So who's gonna buy the Mac Pro? Well, of course, Hollywood and VFX production houses, those guys are gonna pick up tons of these machines and not think twice. What about all these big YouTubers who are buying them left and right? Well, what a lot of people don't realize is for those guys, they're making 30, 60,000 bucks in just one or two videos, maybe in a couple weeks. To drop 50K on a computer that will be able to produce plenty of YouTube content is sort of a drop in the bucket. Plus, it's a big tax write-off. But for you and for me, the average consumer, this Mac Pro just can't be rationalized. I like how Quinn from Snazzy Labs said it on Twitter. Or the comparisons are pretty funny, like a $50,000 computer, or a down payment on a house, or a brand new Tesla. It's pretty crazy. Now, I'm actually not fighting if this is a good deal or not. Features and benefits versus pricing ratio, if you like that cheese grater design or not, I'll let others duke that out. And let's not be deceived, this might be the new flex that a lot of people have. First, it was a red camera a few years back. 8K might be a little overkill for YouTube, some of them might even admit that. Then it was Tesla for the last couple years. Honestly, you're not an official tech YouTuber unless you have a Tesla or two. And now it might be the Mac Pro. Hands down, will it help people export faster and time is precious? Well, for sure, yes. And of course, a lot of this is a little tongue-in-cheek. You can rationalize just about any purchase, especially if you're making $50,000 a week. And yes, the Mac Pro is expensive, but it does have killer specs inside, which is pretty awesome. It's just not for everyone. I think my my biggest encouragement, and maybe for you guys as well, if you're getting into that content creation game, it's just not needed to buy the latest and greatest. You can still create quality content without spending a crazy amount of money. At the end of the day, it's sort of fun and easy to poke fun, but hey, if I was buying a $50,000 computer, I sort of hope you would make fun of me as well. Until I see you next time, guys, let's live authen.tech.